didn't know today would be our last, or that I'd have to say goodbye to you so fast. I'm so numb, I can't feel anymore. I'm praying you'd just walk back through that door and tell me that I was only dreaming. You're not really gone as long as I believe. There will be another angel around the throne tonight. Your love lives on inside of me, and I will hold on tight. It's not my place to question, only God knows why. I'm just jealous of the angels around the throne tonight.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, Holy Spirit, we thank you this morning for your presence. Thank you that you are here to comfort us. And we pray that you will bless us, that you will speak to us, and that you will touch us. We pray that in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let's remain standing while we sing the first hymn on our sheet. Thank you. You all received a sheet to sing. First hymn is What a Friend We Have in Jesus. Thank you. You may be seated. Laat my toe om by hierdie geleentheid ons meegevoel te betuig aan elkeen van die familie met die verlies wat u gelei het, mag die Heere u vandag versterk en u aanraak. Laat mij toe om hier aan die begin een kort levensoorsig voor te hou van Ivan Claude Clouky. Just a short summary of his life. Ivan Claude Clouky was born 9 February 1942 in Queenstown in the Eastern Cape. He also grew up in Queenstown and attended Queen's College Secondary School in Queenstown. Hy het by die poskantoor en ook die Suid-Afrikaanse spoorweë gewerk en was later sakeman en restauranteienaar. Ivan was 'n baie harde werker wat sy werk ernstig opgeneem het, maar hy was ook aan die ander kant 'n grapjas wat jou lekker kon laat lag. He loved music. He was a good chef and he enjoyed good food. Famous artists like Guy Korsten, Sonja Harold, Tommy Dell, Gene Rockwell, Leon Schuster enjoyed dinner in his restaurant regularly. Wow! Ek sou hulle graag allemaal ook wel ontmoet, ne? Hy was lief om houtwerk te doen, maar aan die andere kant het hy glad nie van visvang gehou nie. Ja, daarvoor sal ons hom vergewe, ne? God blessed Ivan with 5 children, and I hope I'm correct, 9 grandchildren, and I hope I'm correct, 9 great-grandchildren. Ivan verhuis na sy ewige tuiste, 12 February 2021, die ouderdom van 79 jaar, and he was so proud to reach that wonderful age of 79. He told Rina and the family, wow, this is great. Ons eer sy nagedagtenis, ons gaan hom mis en gun hom die rus. Through the ages, people have been asking questions about eternity, about life after death. In Luke 16, Jesus gives us a glimpse of heaven and a glimpse of hell. A kykie, net so bietjie inligting, maar genoeg om ons te laat dink. Ek lees vir u Luke 16 from verse 19. There was a rich man who was dressed in purple and fine linen and lived in luxury every day. At his gate was laid a beggar named Lazarus, covered with sores, and longing to eat what fell from the rich man's table. Even the dogs came and licked his sores. The time came when the beggar died, and the angels carried him to Abraham's side. The rich man also died and was buried. In hell, where he was in torment, he looked up and saw Abraham far away with Lazarus by his side. So he called him, "Father Abraham, have pity on me and send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, because I am in agony in this fire." But Abraham replied, "Son, remember Remember. Remember. That in your lifetime you received your good things while Lazarus received bad things. But now he is comforted here and you are in agony. And besides all this, between us and you, a great chasm has been fixed so that those who want to go from here to you cannot, nor can anyone cross over from there to us. He answered, "Then I beg you, Father, send Lazarus to my father's house, for I have five brothers." Remember, I have five brothers. "Let him warn them. Send Lazarus to my father's house, for I have five brothers. Let him warn them so that they will not also come to this place of torment." Abraham replied, "They have Moses and the prophets. They have the Bible. They have the word of God. Let them listen to them." The Bible writers, let them listen to what they wrote. "No, Father Abraham," he said, "but if someone from the dead goes to them, they will repent." He said to them, "If they do not listen to Moses and the prophets, they will not be convinced, even if someone rises from the dead." Hierdie gedeelte begin met die woorde, daar was 'n ryk man en daar was 'n bedelaar met die naam van Lazarus. This is a true story. This is not a parable. 'N gelykenis. Dit het werklik gebeur. It really happened. Hierdie mense het regtig geleef. And both of them died. Al twee het gesterwe. Now Joshua chapter 2 verse 11 says the following. God is in heaven on the other side of death, and God is on earth. God is alomteenwoordig. Hy weet wat aan die ander kant van die graf is, maar hy is ook hier op aarde. God knows exactly what happened to both of these two people. The angels carried Lazarus away, and the rich man died and was buried. Psalm 89 vers 48 en 49 sê, "Dink daaraan dat die lewe kort is." Think about it. Life is short. En wie leef wat die dood nie sal sien nie? Prediker 8 vers 8, "Niemand het mag oor die dag van sy dood nie." I know we don't want to talk about dying, and many people don't prepare for death. In die skole het ons seks onderrig, maar ons praat nie met ons kinders oor die dood nie. Maar as ons grafplaas toe gaan, dan sal jy sien daar lê mense van babietjies tot stokoud. Jong mense, kinders, jeug, middeljariges, senior burgers. In Psalm 13 vers 4 bid die psalmdigter, "Help my dat ek nie in die dood inslaap nie, dat die dood my nie onvoorbereid vang nie. Help me to be ready to meet God." That's what he's praying. Nou wat is die redes vir hierdie gebed? Help my Here to be ready to meet you when I die. Number one, there is life after death. Daar is hiernamaals. Baie mense sê daar's 'n ligleegte, daar's 'n niks, jy sink weg in 'n ewige onbewuste slaap. You're aware of nothing, you're dead. Jesus said in this scripture, there is a heaven, there is a hell. Daar is 'n plek van troos en daar's 'n plek van smarte. Many people say, I don't believe in such nonsense. Let's say that you are right. Kom ons sê, jy is reg, daar is nie 'n hemel nie, daar is nie 'n hel nie. As ek my oë aan die ander kant oopmaak, dan gaan ek nie veel verloor het in die proses nie. Maar sê nou jy's verkeerd. En daar is 'n hemel. En daar is 'n hel. Wat dan? The rich man opened his eyes in hell. He was aware of everything around him. He was in flames. He was in agony. As jy dood is, sê baie mense, dis soos 'n koma, jy's bewusteloos. You know nothing. Hierdie man was bewus van wat om hom aangegaan het. Jy gaan aan die ander kant weet waar jy is en wat om jou aangaan. Hy het Lazarus gesien, he saw Lazarus. You know when you're in hell, you will have a picture of heaven. Jy gaan sien hoe mooi lyk dit daar, hoe wonderlik lyk dit daar, hoe goed is dit om daar te wees. Elkeen van ons is op pad na 'n ewige bestemming. Hebrews 9:27, it is destined that man die only once, after that comes judgment. Geen genade, geen oordeel. Daar's mense wat glo as jy doodgaan is daar 'n vage vuur, daar's 'n suiweringsvuur waar jy gereinig word vir die hemel. Dis nie wat die Bybel sê nie. Na die dood kom die oordeel. No mercy after death. Not even a drop of water. Abraham, send Lazarus with a drop of water. No mercy after death. U sien hier in die smarte van die onuitbluslike vlam is daar 'n diep kloof tussen jou en God, tussen jou en die hemel as jy verlore is. Now it's very interesting. This is a place, hell is a place where people pray. This man prayed, please send somebody to warn my brothers. I'm here today to beg you, pray now. Speak to God now. Ivan prayed every morning the Our Father prayer. Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Listen, and forgive me my trespasses. Forgive me my sin. He prayed it every day. Don't wait till after death. Pray now. Lord, forgive me. Lord, cleanse me of all sin and unrighteousness. Maak nou u saak reg met God. U sien vir elke gelowige, for every believer, waits blessing, God's presence, peace, comfort. When you take the Bible and you read the book of Revelation, man, heaven is a wonderful place. Heaven is a reality like Nigel is a place. Heaven is a place. It's a beautiful place. It's a wonderful place. Hier maak hulle strate van teer. In die hemel is die strate van goud. Hier maak hulle deure van hout. In die hemel is die deure van parels. Hier gebruik hulle sement en klip en sand om die fondasie te gooi. In die hemel is die fundament edelgesteentes. Hier zweet ons en plant ons en ploeg ons en werk ons. In die hemel is daar vruchtebome wat 12 maal een jaar vruchte dra. Geen dood, geen tranen, geen pijn, geen ziekte, geen hartseer, geen scheiding ooit nie. Wow! Ek sal dom wees as ek nie wil hemel toe gaan nie. Een wonderlijke plek. Een plek van veiligheid en troos. I've been to Russia 16 times. My wife says it's 18 times. I can't remember exactly. We're involved in missions, as you can see the flags here. So I can tell you a few things about the Red Square in Moscow. I can tell you a few things about the monuments and the museums, etc., etc., the people and so on, because I've been there 16 times. In John 1 verse 1 and 14, the Bible says, Jesus was with God in heaven, and he came to earth. He became flesh. So Jesus knows exactly what it looks like on the other side of death. And he knows exactly what lives look like on this side. He became a man. And he says, there is life after death. Daar is lewe na die dood. Help my, by die psalmdigter, om nie in die dood in te slaap nie. Want daar is hier namens. Nog een rede, ons geheue word nie uitgewis deur die dood nie. Mense sê, as jy dood is, weet jy niks. Is klaar, is voorbij, oor uit. Maar dis nie waar nie. You will remember everything. After death, he remembered, I've got 5 brothers. You will remember your family. You will remember your wife, your husband, your children, your parents. You will remember them. And he prayed, send somebody to warn them not to end up in this place. He remembered his father's house, his family, his parents, his marriage. And I'm here today to encourage you, give flowers while you can. Because one day you'll remember the good things that you did while you were on earth. Give love now. Give a hug now. Be there for your loved ones now. Make time for people. Share good things with them. You will remember it. He remembered Lazarus. Hy het hom erken. Wow! Ons gaan mekaar daar erken. Mense vra, as ek dood is enig en ons kom in die hemel, sal ons mekaar erken? Ja, hy het Lazarus erken. Hy het hom onthou. Maar hy het ook onthou. Hy het Lazarus niks gegin nie. Not even a piece of bread. Kom ons wees goed vir mekaar. Daai karwag wat in die son en die wind en die weer staan, gee hom iets. Daai restaurant, daai kelner, gee hulle 'n goeie tip. Wees dankbaar. Kom ons maak 'n verskil. Hierdie ryk man het niks gedink van Lazarus nie. Hy was steeds arrogant. Hy het Lazarus gesien soos 'n slaaf. Send him with a drop of water. He's just a servant. Die hel gaan 'n mens nie verander nie. It won't change your life. Hierdie man was precies dieselfde mens in die hel, want daar was 'n spreekwoord wat sê, soos 'n boom val, so bly hy lê. Soos die dood jou vind, so gaan hy jou uitlewer. If you're not saved, you're not a child of God, when you die, death will deliver you into the hands of God, unsaved. He remembered the word of God. Abraham sê vir hom, hulle het die wet en die profete. Die wet is Moses, eerste 5 boeken, die profete is die Ou Testament. Hulle het die Bybel. Ons het Bybels. Leen ons kamers en ons laaikassies, staan op 'n boekrak. Ons het Bybels. Hy het nie gevra, wat is dit nie? Hy het geweet, hy het onthou, dis die Bybel. Ons gaan preke onthou, soos aan die kant kom. Ons gaan begrafnis bijeenkomste onthou, waar ons gesit het. We will remember weddings, where we heard about Jesus. We'll remember the church bells ringing on a Sunday morning. We'll remember Christian songs over the radio. We'll remember the Christmas songs in malls during Christmas time. Christ was born today. Christelike liedjies wat ons aangespreek het. Ons sal het onthou. Ons sal onthou hoe dat ons gewete met ons gepraat het. Ons sal onthou hoe dat God ons geroep het. For this man is too late now. Now he wants to be an evangelist. Lord, send somebody to go and preach to my brothers, to tell them about Jesus. And Abraham said, they've got the word of God. David prays, help me to be ready, Lord. Why? Ons eindbestemming word nie bepaal deur ons status, ons posisie, ons geld nie. Your final destiny is not determined by your bank account, your accomplishments, or your status. I want to say something very important. The rich man is in hell, not because he was rich. And the poor man is in heaven, not because he was poor. Abraham, that this rich man saw in heaven, was one of the richest men in his time. The Bible says he had gold and silver and cattle and horses. He had an army of 218 men. To have weapons of war, to have soldiers, to pay them salaries, to give them food to eat, places to stay, cost a lot of money. He was a very rich man. So it's not about rich or poor. The poor man was not in heaven because he was poor. Listen to what this rich man is saying. He is saying, send somebody to my brothers so that they can repent. So dat ek kan bekeer en in hierdie plek land nie. Repent. Abraham was in heaven, not because he was rich. The Bible says, Abraham believed God. God het Abraham geglo, en daarom is dit hom tot geregtigheid gereken. John 3:16, I want to read it to you. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. Not read the Bible, not pray, all those things, it's very important. Not go to church. Listen. That whoever believes in him, believes the Bible, shall have everlasting life. John 3:36. Whoever believes in the Son has eternal life. But whoever rejects the Son will not see life, for God's wrath remains on him. In 2019, Ivan was sitting more or less over there. Rina was sitting next to him. And I made an invitation in the church. If you want to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior today, just raise your hand. And Ivan did it. And I prayed with him the sinner's prayer, the repentance prayer. Lord, come into my life. Nobody is perfect. Ivan was not perfect. But he did something that is important if you want to live forever with God. Repent. Accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. Live for God with everything you have. U besluit vandag. Bepaal waar u die ewigheid gaan deurbring. Your decision today, your decision on earth determines your eternal destiny. May God help us. For the last time, Ivan is speaking to us. Repent. 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 We have the opportunity today to say, Lord, here we are. Come into our lives. Amen. Heavenly Father, I thank you this morning for your word. I thank you that you warned us, but also you gave us a glimpse of heaven, a place of peace, a place of joy, a place of fullness, no lack, no tears, no pain. Father, thank you this morning that while we were listening to the word, the Holy Spirit was working in our hearts, in our lives, speaking to us, my son, my daughter, give me your heart. Father, we understand that repentance means to turn around, change direction. Jy kan nie aangaan in die koers waarmee jy aangaan nie. You cannot gamble with eternal life. Ons kan nie met die dood en met die hiernamaals dobbel nie. Ons moet omdraai in ons gedagte, in ons hart, in ons wandel, in ons optrede. Repent. Repent. Help us, Lord. Help us today to open our hearts and our minds to you. Thank you that you love us, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son to die on a cross so that we can have eternal life. Dankie Here, dat u vanmôre hier is om met ons te praat en ons lewens te verander. Here, ek bid vir die familie. Pray for every family member that you will wipe the tears from their eyes, that you will comfort them, that you will strengthen them, that you will give them your peace, that your presence will be with them every day, and that hulle sal weet, die Here sal my nooit alleen laat nie. Thank you for the promise in your word. I'm with you till the ends of the earth. Father, thank you that we can give an opportunity now to people to say, I surrender my life to Jesus. I praise you in Jesus' name. While all eyes are closed, almal se oë gesluit, u sê, ek het vanmôre God gehoor praat met my. I don't want to gamble with my eternal life. Ek wil ook vanmôre my saak met God regmaak. Daar waar u sit, gaan u nie vra om op te staan, enigiets te doen nie. Daar waar jy sit, terwijl niemand rondkijk, jy sê, bid vir my, kan jy net die hand opsteek en hom weer laat sak, dan bid ek vir jy. Anybody, if you want me to pray, thank you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, thank you, you can. Dankie, nou nog iemand, ek wil nie onnodig uitrek nie. Today is your opportunity. Hemelse Vader, ek kom nou na u toe in die naam van Jesus, en ek sê dankie vir hierdie persone wat hulle hande opgesteek het, wat sê, vandag neem ek Jesus aan as my saligmaker, redder en verlosser. Vandag sê ek dankie vir die bloed van Jesus, wat ook vir my sonde gevloei het, sodat ek kind van God kan word. Thank you, Father, for touching each one of them. Thank you for changing their lives. Thank you for walking with them the road from today on. Thank you, Father, for speaking to them and taking good care of them. Here, dalk sit hier mense wat sê, ek moes my hand opgesteek, het ek het nie. I pray that you will also bless them and come into their lives. Here, mag gesinne, families, huwelike vandag omgekeer word deur die Here ten goede. Mag daar nuwe vreugde, nuwe blydskap in huwelike kom, in gesinne kom, want Jesus het in ons gesin ingekom. Dankie Here, dat u vir ons reinig met u bloed, dat u vir ons was witter dan die sneeuw. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Ek wil graag die volgende bedankings doen. Ons is gevra om dit te doen. Baie dankie aan al die familie, die kinders, die kleinkinders vir die teenwoordigheid. Thank you for being here this morning. All the family members. Then to Aquila Church, the personnel here, for their assistance. It is appreciated by the family. To Afbob, Jolanda, vir al die reëlings, die vriendelikheid, die bedagsaamheid, hulle het dit makkelijk ook gemaak vir Rina en die kinders. En dan, Rina, baie dankie vir al die lekker kos wat jy vir hom gemaak het. Sy lekker breakfast, ek het gehoor, dat jy hom versorg het. En as hy lus was vir ice cream, dan moes Rina ry. Ons gaan ice cream eet. En baie keer was het sommer net lekker rondry. Dankie vir jou liefde. Ons arbeid in die Here is nie te vergeefs nie. En ek wil weer sê, kom ons doen wat goed is en wat reg is en wat mooi is, terwyl ons die kans het, want ons gaan het onthou eendag. En dit gaan vir ons een soet druppel wees in die beker van ons herinneringe, of het kan een bitter druppel wees in die beker van ons herinneringe. Dylan Clark, you're so welcome to come and say a few words. There you are, welcome.
Hello everybody, for those who don't know me, Ivan was my grandfather. I just wrote a short speech to just dedicate to him. Toppy, Opa, Grandpa, and Dad is only but a few names we called you, but to me, you are always my tops. Toppy, I don't know where to start with the memories. It feels like yesterday, from the wonderful laughs we had, that the tears started to roll, to the talks of serious situations. Who can forget the chasing around after some funny arguments? Toppy, your laugh was golden and your voice irreplaceable. Your knowledge never ending and your cooking, boy, that was something else. Toppy, you are such a loving person, and I'll never forget our bond. You were there to offer me advice in some tough times and to share a laugh in some good times and to cry with me when that was needed. Who can I call now for when I need advice? And who can show me some joint tactics that ups my arts? Tantirina, thanks for making Toppy's last 2 years so happy. He couldn't stop talking about you, and I'll be forever grateful. My sincere gratitude to everyone present here today to pay tribute to the amazing man I could call my grandfather. I found rest in the fact that he's with God our Father, and he's getting a well-deserved rest. Rest easy, Grandpa, and enjoy singing with the angels and watching over us.
Thank you. God bless you. Thank you. We're going to sing a second hymn, but before we do that, I want to read these wonderful words to you. Will you please rise while we read this? In memory, loving memory of Ivan Claude Clokey, born 9 February 1942, passed away 12 February 2021. Our family chain. We little knew that morning that God would call your name. In life, we loved you dearly. In death, we do the same. It broke our hearts to lose you, but you did not go alone. For part of us went with you the day God called you home. You left us beautiful memories. Your love is still our guide. And though we cannot see you, you are always by our side. Our family chain is broken, and nothing seems the same. But as God calls us one by one, the chain will link again, deeply mourned by his wife, children, grandchildren, family, and friends. When I read out the names of the pallbearers, they're welcome to come to the front. Daniel Fletcher, Melanie Potgieter, Ivan Clokey, Stuart Clark, Dylan Clark, Arthur Hennam. Let's sing the last hymn on our sheet, How Great Thou Art.
Consider all the worlds thy hands have made. I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art. How great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation to take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art.
Congratulation to Dave and Raoul de Toue, and also to Victor Cloakey for contributing financially to make this funeral available. May God bless you. We really appreciate it. And Victor, it's your birthday today. Happy birthday. May God bless you. And to have your birthday and celebrate it on a day like this, well, you'll always remember your dad's funeral. May God bless you. All the pallbearers, you can come forward. Net 'n paar reëlings. Wanneer die kus binne in die lijkswaar is, gaan u geleentheid kry om die laaste eer te bewys, blomme te strooi. En daarna wil ons vra dat u weerskante van die rypad sal gaan staan, 'n laaste erewag vorm. En die naaste familie kan dan agter die lijkswa aanstap tot by die hek. Daar by die hek sal die lijkswa oomblik stilhou net vir 'n laaste, vir 'n last goodbye. Is it okay with you? Kom ons ontvang die seën van die Here. En nou mag die genade van ons Here Jesus Christus, die liefde van God ons Vader, en die gemeenskap van die Heilige Gees met ons allemaal wees en bly totdat Jesus kom.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found. Was blind, but now I see. T'was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear, the hour I first believed. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already come. 'Tis grace that brought me safe thus far, and grace will